Leveling up, extreme business growth through raising your game. When what was once extraordinary becomes ordinary, you know you've leveled up.
Hello and welcome to the Leveling Up podcast with me, George Swift. The Leveling Up podcast is here to give you the personal development, the entrepreneurial development, and the business growth that you, the ambitious business owner, desires. I'm here to give you the inspiration, the motivation, and to challenge your aspirations to take you and your business to the next level. Today, it is our Friday 5-Minute Fix. They are never 5 minutes, however, they are always on a Friday, and they are abbreviated, shortened podcast episodes designed specifically to just get you thinking about one particular aspect of entrepreneurism, of business, to take that into the weekend, to cogitate over the weekend, come back on Monday, maybe implement, and then get firing on all cylinders. Today, I want to share with you a learning from the Chilean miners. Now, the Chilean miners, if you remember, back in 2010, was a horrific, horrendous incident. 33 men trapped 700 meters underground, and they were 3 miles away from the entrance to the mine. 3 miles away from the entrance, 700 meters underground, when the mine collapsed. They were trapped. They were in darkness. They were hungry. They were thirsty. They had nothing down there. They had nothing apart from some hope. Some hope, some trust, some faith, some belief that someone was going to come and help them, that somehow they could get out of this horrific set of circumstances. And I remember kind of trying to picture what it must be like down there. And even if you got the slightest glimpse of what life down there must be like, not just the conditions, but the emotions that you must be feeling trapped down there, it was anxiety inducing. So it was big news back then. And here's the thing. Every single man came out alive. They saved, they rescued every single one of them. However, they were trapped down there for 69 days. Over 3 months, they were stuck down this mine. And how they survived, or one of the ways they survived, was they needed to keep themselves mentally strong. They had to hold themselves mentally together. And they did. And the way they did this was they became a support group for each other. So they understood, and it was evident, that not everyone was going to hold their shit together all the time. Not being funny, you and I, you know, we struggle to hold our shit together, and we're perfectly safe up top. So what happened was, at any point in time, there was a number of Chilean miners that were absolutely standing strong. They were optimistic, positive, and they were able to support some of the miners that were not holding themselves together very well, that were having a particularly negative time. And then what happened was, is the ones that were strong would inevitably at some point crack. You can't do 69 days straight, okay? Eventually you're going to crack. And when the ones that were strong cracked, the ones that had previously being not so strong and being supported by them, were now in a position to support them. So what happened was, you had these 33 men at any point in time, some of them were absolutely losing their shit, and some of them were absolutely holding their shit together. And between them, they supported themselves through the entire 69 days. That unquestionably has got to be one of the reasons these people survived this long. Keeping themselves together, keeping their mindset together, stopping themselves going crazy. Does this make sense? It's the same in business, it's the same in life. Not even close to the same degree, mark you. But if they can make it work down there, we can certainly make it work up here. So what that means is this: don't expect yourself to be like perfect all the time. Don't put so much pressure on yourself to expect that you somehow have to keep all your shit together all the time, perfectly and permanently. When you have a little meltdown, you have a breakdown, you have a cry, you go and hide under the duvet for a day or two, understand, so does everybody else. You might not see it, but everybody does. We all have our strong times and our weak times. And I've said this across the whole of success groups and the whole of our masterminds. You know, at any point in time, there's probably a third of the group that's absolutely smashing it. A third of the group that's kind of doing okay. And there's a third of the group that's really struggling. But it's not the same people all the time. You know, the people that are really flying today will be the ones that struggle at some point in the future. And the ones that are struggling now, at some point, will be the ones to support the others in the future. And we hold ourselves together in a very similar way. Now, the reason this story really came to light to me is because one of my success group members said, this is what success groups is. Now, I'm not going to sit there and say, right, it's the same intensity, you know, in business as it is being buried alive for 69 days. I get that, right? But the principles are the same, which is inevitably, you are going to lose your shit at some times. Inevitably, you're not going to be able to hold it together. You're going to be negative, pessimistic, unmotivated, undriven. You're going to feel maybe like a failure. You're going to feel like, what's the point? We all go through it. Me, I run the club. I deliver all the content. I write the content. I, on some occasions, and it's not just necessarily like a day or here and a day there, but periods of time where I feel really strong in myself. And my self-esteem is strong, my confidence is strong, and I'm really firing and I'm really rocking. And other times, you know, I'm a little bit under the weather, I'm a little bit pessimistic. Doesn't last for long. But I tell you now, if you're left on your own, that can start to spiral down. It can start to feel very lonely, you can start to feel very alone, and then very quickly, you don't necessarily possess the skills or the ability to pull yourself back up, and you can lose yourself down there. And one of the strongest things we do at Success Groups in our masterminds is that we provide environments where this kind of camaraderie exists, where people are doing really well and are feeling strong and supportive and can nurture the ones that aren't feeling so strong. And the ones that aren't feeling so strong, when they get their shit together, they'll be the support for other people. And it's in flux. It's in flux. I see it. Even my business owners who are doing £1 million plus, right? They still have periods where they are absolutely got all their shit together. And there's periods where they definitely start to lose their shit. The group together supports us. I see it in my mastermind. I saw it this week, in fact, in my mastermind. So in this mastermind, I've got businesses in there doing from low hundreds of thousands of turnover all the way up to like nearly £10 million. Now, one of my bigger businesses in there doing multiple millions of pounds has been a constant source of support and help and nurture for the other businesses in that group, especially some of the smaller businesses. Now, he's going through a particularly rough time right now, but guess what? The other businesses that he's been supporting over these years were all there for him. And he's leaning on them and he's allowing them to support him and he's allowing them to be the support, the nurture, the motivation, the kick up the arse, all these things that he needs right now, all the things that he's been for other people, he now gets the support of that back when he needs it. So here's the thing, no matter how big your business is, don't think for a minute that you're expected to hold your shit together all the time. No matter how small your business is, don't think for a minute that somehow you're never going to be successful because everybody else around you seems to have their shit together and you keep losing your shit. You know, don't think like that. We all have periods where we hold our shit together. A lot of shit's in this episode. We hold our shit together. We all have periods where we lose our shit a little bit. When you have the right team, the right culture, the right environment around you, you become the support to others when they need it. They become the support to you when you need it. And just like the Chilean miners, it can absolutely save you from losing your mind. Make sure you get a group of people around you like that. This is kind of following on from a podcast just on Wednesday this week. And it would be remiss of me not to say this. If you don't have this kind of environment around you or near you or one that you can create for yourself, I have created one for you. This isn't a sales pitch, but it's really simple. Success groups and our extreme growth masterminds have been designed specifically with this in mind. To educate people, to grow people, to give you an environment to stimulate you, to challenge your aspirations, to get you thinking bigger, to get you achieving your goals, doing what you need to do consistently to get the results that you want. But also, I'm telling you now, to be the support, to be the nurture, to be the group of people that can lean on each other and support each other and lift each other up in the tougher times. Okay, guys, nice one. If you're a smaller business and you haven't yet hit 100K, don't forget the six-figure fast track is waiting for you. It's a webinar specifically designed with the five-figure service-based business in mind. You might be doing 20, 30, 40, 50,000, I don't know, maybe even 60,000 in turnover per year. But you want to know, what's it going to take to hit 100 grand or more in the next 12 months or less? Get yourself on the six-figure fast track, biggerbrighterbolder.co.uk/fast-track. You'll find it there. I'll drop that link in the descriptions below. Have an awesome weekend doing whatever it is that you are doing. If you're working, keep it productive. If you're using it as a time to recharge, then use that time wisely. Come back on Monday, smash the hell out of it. I look forward to seeing you then. And as always, until then, be successful.
Leveling up. Extreme business growth through raising your game. When what was once extraordinary becomes ordinary, you know you've leveled up.